Hey, welcome back to Two Super Guys Trade Stocks. I'm Dylan.
And I'm Vinny.
We're going to talk about why some fund managers just sold TLT, made a video on it, and why we are thinking it is almost, it's like ripe for the picking. It's almost there. Not quite, but right there. We're going to talk about it.
Two Super Guys Trade Stocks.
All right. Let me give these guys some credit real quick. So they, manage other people's money in some capacity called Before the Bell. They have a video talking about why they sold TLT. So naturally, Vinny sent it to me before he watched. He's like, oh, man.
I mean, they got pretty nice haircut and like that, like, you know, middle-aged, successful, like tan, you know? I golf a lot.
Okay, sure.
That's like 10 points of credence right there.
Pertinent information is all we do. Essentially, what they were talking about is it may actually be smarter to not buy TLT and to buy the treasury bond itself. They're not disagreeing with the thesis of what me and Vinny have been saying for like a year now, and it's almost time to come to fruition. It's right there. I wanted this last rate hike, so we were there, but not. It's just,
hey, the bond price has still moved, so.
Yeah. Oh, I know. I'm going to show that too. But they're saying it's actually better, and why they sold TLT, to just go straight bonds, get what we would see here as a, 4.7% yield on their cash, and then, you know, sell the capital gains as soon as it comes. So we're going to compare these two options. I'm also, everyone keeps on saying they're in TMF and talking about options. I think it's a bad idea. You do you. I'm. Who am I to tell anyone what to do? I don't know what I'm doing. but I'm going to talk about it real quick, just so we could get these numbers correct. TLT has a dividend of 3.82%. All right.
Dividend
so that
yield.
Has to be,
3.82%.
Yes.
The dividend yield is 3.82%.
Sorry. Yes. So that has to be factored in. Okay. So the yield for the treasury bond is 4.7. Granted that changes like every day, give or take a little bit. The fees for TLT, 0.15%. Okay? Boom, boom.
Yeah.
Move your face. So TLT versus straight bonds. The reason why I'm still on TLT, although the bond is interesting, I'm still considering it, is you can still do the wheel strategy with TLT. You still get the 3.82% dividend. You do have to pay the expense ratio. The treasury bond, you get the 4.7% yield. Both of these have the exact same thesis. Mm-hmm. Interest rates have to come down at some point. And, well, they don't have to. See the risk for both right there. Logically, they're most likely going to come down, so we'll both benefit in the same way. The risk is America defaults on its debt. Our world is over. And the economy somehow starts killing it. I don't know how that would happen.
People have been pretty resistant, you know. I went out shopping with my wife this morning, and god damn it, there's still 8,000 idiots out there buying every stupid piece of Halloween crap they can get their hands on. The economy is still going very, very hot. I will say that.
Yeah, I would agree, surprisingly. I'm going to talk about a little bit just the wheel strategy, because a lot of people will say, hey man, this is a bond ETF. This does not respond to levels like stocks. I hear you, but here is, 20 examples of where you're wrong. Here is me zooming out to like 2010, and you can see these levels drawn from the past going forward are, they're great. It's beautiful. They like hit within like 50 cents every single time and bounce. I don't understand it, but it works.
It does.
You have to understand it.
I just want to see you try that argument with your wife sometime. Just let me know how it works out. There's 20 examples of why you're wrong.
20 examples of why you're wrong. Yeah, perfect. That's going to go real well. This is actually from the inception of the ETF. So this is all the way back to, it's like super zoomed out, 2002. Okay. You can see from 2002, we never went below about 81-ish. Okay. I'm going to show you that again in a second. But real quick, here's just a zoom in recently showing you. I don't know why it works, guys. It just does. Here's almost to the penny on these things, on this level of like 91.70. The buy points are 92, 87, 82. We are chilling at about 91.50 right now. Right?
Yeah. Yeah, we're pretty close to like that first target zone you have.
Right. Let me go back one slide. There was one time where we dipped below 82. You have to zoom in, but it was for like a day or two. It's not important. But you can tell just from the inception, even through the bank crisis, did this have a massive dip here? Yeah, we went all the way back down to this 87 level, bounced a couple of times throughout, you know, as it was healing, and then rocket time.
Yeah. You know, it's, I don't know. Call me crazy. I just watched a video of a guy arguing basically that bears trade on this, but it's like we are at currently 92. The all-time low is like 81, and all-time high is like 175. Like to me, that represents a lot of asymmetric risk, particularly when you consider the fact the United States will stimulate. It's without a doubt we can't survive without stimulus and quantitative easing. It will happen at some point in time. There will be another crisis, and they'll be able to address it with a bazooka of cash again, and TLT will be a massive winner in that environment.
Yeah, it's kind of what Charlie Munger said. You know, the rule is never put more than like 5%. Well, it depends on who you listen to. 5% into any one stock. But then Charlie Munger would be like, sometimes we'll put 50. If it's like a unique opportunity, I don't think we're going to have this opportunity again for like 10 years. I really don't. You know, as people know, I shorted this. Just it was very obvious. I don't think I'm going to have a chance to go long again. Here is the if you look at the very middle of these green bars, the mm-hmm. like the literal, the very middle, that's the day that each one of these, there is a rate hike from Jerome Powell, and then the corresponding yeah. number next to it. You can see the wheel strategy would not have worked as the first half, just because they were 75 point rate hikes. They were extremely aggressive. There was a lot of variability in the movements, but these 25 rate hikes are pretty easy. I've been doing puts on these fairly successfully using the support lines of 92 and 87. I have one at 90 right now.
Interesting.
Yeah, I do think that this is still better than a bond as long as you don't get cocky and you try to sell like in the money calls, like, well, I know it's going to go down. Well, that's okay. That's going to be a problem.
Yeah,
or in the money covered right calls.
That's a Vinny level move right there, and it does not always work out very well.
Yeah. So I do think that this is a pretty unique opportunity. I still like TLT more just because if you do covered calls, and let's say you're crazy safe and you go like beyond 2 points of or two support lines, you would only have to make up 1% of the difference from the TLT to the bond. It's not mm-hmm. entirely accurate, but it's close enough. It's about 1%.
Sure.
I know a lot of people are saying they're in TMF. I'm not saying I won't do TMF, but I'm not going to touch it for at least 12 months or maybe 15 months. And that could still be a lie. I would need like 12 months of no rate decreases and then seeing inflationary data continuously get like improve. Because you've said this before, as rates can go down incredibly fast.
Yes. This is like a doomsday kind of scenario, but let's say like, 2 hours after we record this, China invades Taiwan, right? And like the global economy is completely thrown into disarray. What is the Federal Reserve going to do tomorrow, probably? Going to cut rates to zero.
Yeah. And yeah. I mean, you can't really plan for those situations. So yeah. I would be called out there. But going forward, I like for the covered calls, I'm going to completely avoid all Fed meetings. I'm just no expirations anywhere near that time. And like I said, options, the theta decay on those, especially for a possible 2-year hold here, is not worth it.
Same with when you're using a triple levered ETF like this is the TMF, you are paying triple or even more so it's 0.15 to like 1.5% almost in terms of like a 10x in terms of your management fees. That's how much it increases by when they're having to manage a triple level product. That's not exactly, I think theirs is like 1.06%, but it's in the same kind of like ballpark. It's kind of, I'm giving you an extreme example of how much more involved it is to manage a triple level ETF, it seems like.
Yeah. All right, guys, let us know what you think, the best vehicle for this trade is. Is it possible that TLT, you know, interest rates go sky high because, you know, America defaults on their debt? Sure. But then everything sucks. Like your bank account, everything is dead. So it's like, it's just dead in this vehicle. So, you know, who cares? Just bullets and food are the only thing that matter at that point.
Yes, exactly.
All right, guys.
That's excellent.